Why shouldn't I shut off my equipment? Jeff in Center Barnstead, New Hampshire wants to know. The hell is Center Barnstead? New Hampshire is such a small state. I'm sure it's somewhere cool. Hi, Paul. I often hear you say not to turn off equipment and just leave it in standby mode. Yep. That today's modern equipment, like TVs, are made to be left in standby. I have a pair of your Stellar M700 monoblocks and Stellar preamp and DAC. Good job. That's some good stuff. And my question is, what are the advantages and disadvantages of leaving it in standby over turning it off completely from the switch in the rear, as I am currently doing? Won't leaving it in standby mode affect the sound or life over time? I read your book 99% True, and actually you read it to me, in the audiobook. I enjoyed it so much, I actually listened to it twice. Whoa, good job. Thank you, Jeff, that's very kind. Well, we get this question a lot, and I'm going to stick to my guns here. Leave it on. Don't be turning it off in the back. So there's several reasons why. First, it isn't a big deal. Okay, this really isn't a big deal. But if we're going to do it right, let's leave it on the way we intended. So I'll tell you a little story. Years ago, when Stan and I started PS Audio back in 1974, we really disliked the idea of turning equipment off. And we didn't like it because every time we turned the power off to a piece of equipment, we had to wait for it to warm up. And we started noticing that over time, equipment that stayed on for long, long periods of time, longer than the time that we would be using them, they sounded better. I mean, you'd leave it overnight and come in and you'd think, well, maybe it's just that my ears are fresh. No, it was more than that. It was something that we really started noticing, how much better something sounded with burn-in time, with on time. So much so that we decided that we weren't going to offer power switches with our equipment. We weren't going to allow you to turn the equipment off. There wasn't even a standby switch. Nothing. And I mean, that's how adamant we were about this whole thing, because we knew that one of the ways we were going to succeed as a company was to be able to prove to people that our products sounded great. And to the extent that they sounded great, we'd sell more of them. And we knew that if they were left on, we'd have an advantage over products that were routinely turned off from the front panel. I mean, used to be, there was no such thing as a standby switch. Those came into being much later when remote controls started coming around. Because how do you turn it out of standby with a remote control if it's not on, right? So at that time, we thought, well, we're going to have a leg up. We're just going to be adamant about this, and we're not going to give you a switch. So I know there were a number of people who hated that, and they used to cut our cords and put little inline switches on it so they could turn it on or off, completely against what we had hoped to do. So here's another factor. Every time that you flick on the power and you plug something in, there is a surge of energy filling up the capacitors in the power supply. And every time you do that, you put a little bit of strain on those caps. Now, it's not a big deal, but over 10 or 20 years of doing that, you're going to fatigue some of the parts more than you would had you just left it on. So from a longevity standpoint, you're far better off not turning the power on and off. From a sound standpoint, you are better off leaving it on, which is why we put the standby switch on it. So yeah, I'm sticking to my guns on that one. Now, the only caveat to that are vacuum tubes. So if you're using vacuum tubes, then you don't want them on all the time because they degrade over time where transistors don't. And capacitors and things are just happy as could be left on. So for vacuum tubes, turn it off. And here's a great example. Our vacuum tube products, the Stellar M1200, which is going to be out here just in a few days, if it isn't already when you see this, our BHK preamplifiers and power amplifiers, those products are tube-based, and the standby switch turns off the vacuum tube but keeps the solid-state equipment on and warm. So, hope that helps your understanding. Don't turn it off if you want good sound and long life. Okay. Thanks. Talk to you tomorrow. Bye. Thank you.